Hey guys, Bowler here to answer 20 of you guys' submitted questions about SCF2 Beta. I picked the 20 most popular and most asked questions I could answer for this video. There were over 300 comments in the last video, so don't feel bad if yours wasn't picked. There was just too many to cover in one video. If you guys really seem to like this video, then I might be able to do another one in the future, so if there's any questions I don't answer in this video, then you can leave them in the comments below. Anyways, moving on to the first question. Darius Johnson asks, does Sheik have bouncing fish? Yeah, she does, and unlike in Smash 4, it actually replaces her side B. It's a pretty fun move, and I think it'll make for some interesting gameplay. MK Zare asked, do you think Meta Knight is better in 9B or Beta? So this is a more opinionated question, and I'd say, while it's hard to know for sure, I think Meta Knight is better in 9B. To be fair, Meta Knight is generally considered the best character or one of the best in 9B, so it would make sense for him to be at least toned down a little bit in Beta. With that being said, I still think Meta Knight is one of the best characters, definitely within my top 10 personally, and he still has a lot of his main strengths. Meta Knight asks, does Kirby have his yellow/orange costume? Yeah, he does, and he also has his orange color and his yellow-green color as well. Happy Frozen Fire asks if there's any noticeable changes to the character speeds and engine changes in Beta. I'd say the biggest change to character speeds from 9B to Beta is with aerial momentum. In 9B, if you try and jump backwards out of a dash, you kind of jump in place, like this. But in SF2 Beta, you can jump backwards out of a dash, allowing you to do a sort of fade back aerial. It's a really welcome change, and I personally enjoy it a lot. I hope that helps answer your question. FFCFG wants to know, who's the most changed character in Beta? In my opinion, I'd say Mega Man without a doubt. He's a character whose almost entire moveset was changed. It's a nice blend of Smash 4 Mega Man, SF2 Mega Man, and even just entirely new moves. He's pretty fun to play, and I think you guys will enjoy him a lot. Miratrix asks, does TK have cargo throws? The answer is yes, he does. It's actually really cool, and I can't wait to see the combos you guys come up with. Of course, he also has his classic DK cargo throw up air combo. Jarky asks, who's the most fun character? Of course, this is a very subjective question and it's all about my opinion, but I'm really enjoying Tails so far. Tails is a lot of fun and he still has most of his advanced tech from 9B. I never really played him that much in 9B, but his beta rework is just super enjoyable. Alberto wanted to know who I think are the best three characters. Now before I say who I think they are, I just want you guys to know that because this game isn't public yet, anything can be changed before release, and it's hard to know who really is the best. But besides that, I'd say my top three characters right now are probably Falco, Fox, and Bandana D. B-Dub wants to know what my favorite costume is in Beta. Picking one costume in Beta is hard since there's such a great variety of great looking costumes. So here's four of my favorites. Light Green Tails, Blue Peach, Darker Green Link, and Purple Mega Man. Hydromancer wants to know if there's any changes to Pikachu's up B. Pikachu's up B in Beta has an increase in knockback similarly to Smash 4. I hope that helps answer your question. Ida wanted to know what I thought of Sonic in Beta. I'd say Sonic is a better character in Beta, but he's a character who I think takes a lot of experience to master. He's not super easy to pick up, but his potential is very high. Combined with his new forward air, he has some really flashy combos he can pull off. Strife asks, who received the biggest buffs and biggest nerfs in Beta? This is actually two questions in one, but I'll let it slide. As for buffs, I'd probably go with Ness. Ness got some great changes to his up tilt, back air, and down air that I think will help him a lot, and potentially make him a high to top tier. As for nerfs, it's really hard to know for sure, but I'd probably go with Pikachu. Since Thunder no longer spikes, and his up air has a harder hitbox to spike with, it's much harder for Pikachu to get kills and edgeguards. Krapikul, I hope I'm pronouncing that right, asks, are there any new tournament legal stages? It's up to the community as a whole to choose what's legal and what's not, but I do think there's a couple of stages that could be legal. Both Galaxy Tours and Saturn Valley have fairly competitive layouts and are new to SF2 Beta. If the community accepts them, they could be tournament legal. Artex wants to know if there's any new tech in Beta that could affect the metagame. And the answer is yes, there actually is. My personal favorite is the addition of shield dropping. By holding the shield and walk/run button on a platform, and then pressing down, you can drop through a platform. For competitive players, this is a pretty big deal. It allows you to escape shield pressure on a platform easier, and lets you punish people like Marth from attacking you below. Outdoor Frack wants to know, Fox or Falco? Falco. Pep Ranger asks, who do you main in Beta? It's been really hard for me to find a main in Beta because I just love so many of the characters. I want to spend time learning them all and it's really hard for me to choose right now, but I'd probably go with Tails or Falco, those are my two favorites. Skylar asks, how much does the quality settings affect lag? If you have a lower end computer, don't worry, there's lower settings for FPS issues and you should be fine. And to finish things off, MMDestroyer973 asked me, is Beta really fun? Yes, yes it is. Thank you guys so much for watching, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'm sorry if I didn't get to answer your question. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed.